Hi, this is the ritual healing in the Temple of Carnelian. If you have pieces of carnelian crystal, jewelry with carnelian, or even orange, red, or brown colored cloth, crystals, clothing, or candles, you may like to bring them into your sacred space for this healing. Once you have created your warm ritual space, sit comfortably with your spine in an upright position and close your eyes, taking your breath and your awareness deep into your belly. Be aware of a light growing in the belly, warm and strong. Imagine following the light into the belly. Deeper and deeper you go until you become aware of a vast pyramid made of huge ancient sandstones with swirling sand patterns on its face. It is a warm, pulsating, alive with energy. Take your time to sense the entrance to the pyramid. You feel effortlessly drawn towards the entrance, and you descend quickly into the pyramid itself now. Inside there is darkness and warm torches of rich flames. As your sense of awareness adjusts to being inside the pyramid, you sense warmth and vibrancy. There is an altar with flames burning and huge bowls made of carnelian. The warm red-orange tones and the light of the fire burning create a golden glow in the room. You just feel the power, warmth, and energy in the temple warming you from within. You become aware of a great being stepping out from behind the altar into the center of the temple. Her energy is powerful and her presence is very strong. She steps forward as a golden lion-headed goddess, vibrant and radiant like the sun. She sweeps her hand before your eyes, placing a soft filter before your eyes so that whilst you are in the temple, you can gaze at her without being blinded by her intensity and light. She is radiant and powerful, fierce and filled with heat and energy like the sun. You bow your head in deep respect and she nods in acknowledgement. She gestures to the largest carnelian bowl filled with fire in the center of her carnelian temple. You notice the fire in the bowl gazing into its dancing flames. You know that she is offering you use of the central flame. It will purify any matter that you offer it. You can choose to release it into the fire. You can choose to release into the fire any fear, doubt, uncertainty, or habit that would hold you back from fulfilling your high destiny and allowing life to flow through you to the greatest degree. It won't always feel comfortable. Sometimes it will feel challenging and scary. But even with that, underneath it, it will always feel right. Do you dare surrender energies that would hold you back into her divine fire? Once the fire segment consumes and destroys these energies, she will give them back transformed. But you will not leave her temple the same as you entered. Are you ready and willing for your own transformation to occur? She waits for one moment longer and then steps forward. It is time for you to decide. She deftly raises her arms and the fire leaps. Now is the time to toss away that which no longer need. Do it now. Feel the exhilaration as you let it go. Let yourself moan or release a cry as you do so. Let your entire body, mind, and soul release into her magnificent fire. When you are done, moments later, the fire dies away, and within the bowl there is golden dust. Feel the peace in the temple and the knowing in Sekhmet's eyes as she inclines her head, acknowledging that you have trusted her and received her healing grace. Be at peace within yourself now. Sekhmet waves her hand over the golden dust in the carnelian bowl, and it gathers itself in swirling light all around you. Let it settle in your body, your chakra, your hair. When the swirling has finished, Sekhmet is gone, and you are outside the pyramid again, traveling back quickly towards your belly and breath flowing. You are changed. Well done. Take your time and be aware of yourself in this space. When you're ready, just open your eyes. So then there's an incantation to the fire belly of Sekhmet. You can say this incantation to overcome any fear or doubt you could possibly imagine, to get energy and fire into any use, any issues that seem stagnant or blocked. Only use the incantation when it really feels right to do so in your heart, because it is so powerful and it will have an effect. And sometimes when your heart tells us patience is needed, we are better to wait and allow situations to unfold rather than to throw the gauntlet down and ask powerful Sekhmet to step in and sort it all out. She isn't very subtle. So, however, when we really do need the power of her action, our beloved Lion Sister Priestess is here for us. Just don't expect to control the effects of her power. Always say the incantation as a whole, so you are calling on unconditional love to guide the process. So here goes the incantation. Sekhmet, who loves me unconditionally, brave, bright as fire, bold as can be, bless the situation with your healing power. Do it now, this very hour. I offer you love and gratitude from my heart as you liberate me from this troubled dark. Sekhmet, who loves me with passion and might, you assist me now with your eternal fire bright. And there you go. That is your ritual. I hope you enjoyed that. Faith, trust, and pixie dust.